Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I wanted to share some bags that I'm on the fence about. So these are bags that I have looked at. They've been added to my wish list. They've been taken off of the wish list. I'm very wishy-washy and I'm just so on the fence. And so I thought, hey, you guys are experts. You folks have great perspective and I would love to just hear your thoughts if you own any of these bags and can provide any insight of yes, I should get it or no, Tarina, you should pass for these reasons. The first bag that I'm on the fence about is from Prada. So it is the Prada re-edition bags. And I say bags because I keep going back and forth between the Prada re-edition 2000 and the 2005. So if you're not familiar, Prada did a re-edition, so that's why they're called the re-edition, of these silhouettes. So these were very popular in the early 2000s, hence the names, and they came back and they were super popular. They come in these gorgeous colors and the standard black in the nylon. They also recently released these versions in leather as well, which are super cute. But I think if I do invest in the Prada re-edition, it would definitely be the nylon because it's just so nostalgic. I just remember the early 2000s with everyone carrying and rocking their nylon Prada bags. So why am I on the fence about these? So the reason I'm on the fence is I think they're super cute. Again, they bring back that nostalgic memory and I feel like I love them. I just don't know which version I would go for and which color I would go for. So again, there's the 2000 and the 2005. If you're not familiar, one version has just a top handle. So you just kind of wear it top handle or you can sling it over your shoulder. It's super cute. And then there is the other version that comes with the top handle, but the top handle of the bag is a chain. And then it comes attached with a crossbody strap, kind of guitar thicker strap, and the little pouch. So very similar kind of silhouette to the multi-pochette accessoire, and Prada, you know, has come out with that version as well. So very similar in that aspect. So the version with the strap, again, you can wear it with the strap crossbody. You can also take it off and wear it top handle, but the top handle, as opposed to the other style, is a chain. So I go back and forth. I look at photos online and I love both. So that's the first bag that I'm on the fence about, is the Prada re-editions, the 2000 versus the 2005, black versus color. So please, if you own this or if you have any strong feelings, let me know below. Okay, the next bag that I'm on the fence about, and this one I've been on the fence about for years, literally years. This is the Celine box bag. So this is a very classic bag. It is so gorgeous. It is a square silhouette and it has the leather crossbody strap, and it's very simple with the metal golden clasp opening. And it's very understated, which I love. I feel like the style and versatility is very classic. So I've, again, this bag, for some reason, I've loved it for many years, but there's also something about it that I just haven't pulled the trigger. It doesn't push me over to, I need it right now. And so it's kind of been one of those bags in limbo. So I would love to hear your thoughts. I know people love the box bag, and those who own it, you know, say that it's kind of a forever bag for them. I do love crossbody bags. So please let me know if you own a box bag or if you don't like the box bag. Just please tell me, help sway me one way or the other for the Celine box bag. Okay, the next bag on my bags on the fence kind of limbo bags is from Louis Vuitton, and it is the Mini Dauphine. So this again is also a newer silhouette from Louis Vuitton. It comes with the monogram print, and it also comes with the reverse monogram as well, kind of accents. It is super cute. I did try this one on in store. I did do a Louis Vuitton shop with me video a month or two ago, so I will link that up there if you wanna check it out. It's super cute. I feel that the size is really perfect. I do like, you know, mini bags, but I feel like it can fit capacity wise a lot of great items. And I've wore it and tried it on in that video. My sales associate showed me multiple ways that you can wear it. So on the shoulder or crossbody, it's really, really versatile and super cute. I am on the fence about it because, again, I think it's super cute, super gorgeous. I've looked at photos of it, but I don't know. Again, I don't get that feeling of, oh my God, I need to have it like right now, but it is really gorgeous. Okay, the next bag here on my list is from Dior. So, the Lady Dior. Please help me decide. Again, Lady Dior, I'm sure most of you know what bag that is. It's a very, very, very classic silhouette from the house. It's super gorgeous. It's very ladylike. You know, going back to many years ago when I first saw this, I thought that I wanted it in the medium size, which is the very classic structured silhouette. But when I was doing research and watching videos and hearing feedback about it, the reason I hesitated or didn't just take the plunge was because the medium, if you don't know, has the standard zipper opening and it's pretty stiff. So when people tried to get in and out of their bag, you know, just opening it and trying to get their hand in, it was, people said that, you know, the zipper would kind of scratch their hand, or it was very tight and just a little difficult, user-friendly, you know, wasn't user-friendly as a lot of other bags day to day. So I kind of held on that, and it came with the classic, you know, thin leather strap. So again, this is just the classic medium style that they have had for a number of years. So again, gorgeous. I've had it on my wish list, but I just haven't taken the plunge. More recently, they have come up with a few other variations of the Lady Dior. The really tiny Lady Dior that I've seen is really cute. It comes with a smaller chain crossbody strap that you can wear. Super gorgeous. I've seen people rock that little mini kind of size. They also have, and with that, they have made a change to that silhouette. They know that people have had that difficulty opening that zipper compartment to access their items. So they took away that and they just made a really user-friendly flap so you can get easily in and out. So I really like that new opening style for the Lady Dior. So I highly recommend that. So there's that mini size. There's also the, I think, the small size. Again, I'm not super familiar, so please educate me if you folks know more about the Lady Dior sizes. it's the size up from that little kind of mini one with the chain, and you can personalize and add charms to the strap. I've seen people add their initials and it's really, really cute. I like that version as well. Okay, next bags. There are two bags from my favorite house, Chanel. So, which is actually surprising. I typically, you know, with Chanel, it's like, oh, I love it, or it's not for me. These have been on the fence, and I'll tell you why. So the first is the Coco handle. So again, I'm sure you all of you know what bag that is. It's a top handle bag. It has a flap. It comes in the caviar quilted leather with a gorgeous CC logo on the front. And it comes with a shoulder strap with the interlocking leather chain detail. super gorgeous, super classic. I feel like in the past few years, it's become, you know, kind of a classic. It's definitely, it's not a classic to the house, so it's not a bag that they carry every throughout every season, but it's so popular for, I think, just the look, the price point, the usability. I think it's super cute. The reason I'm on the fence is, again, for the size. So I don't know what size I would get. I know, so there is the mini. I know they just recently came out with an extra mini, which is like a really tiny version, but I'm talking about the original mini size or the small size for capacity wise. So those are super cute. Another thing that I'm not sure about that I've heard some feedback about the Coco handle is if you are wearing it on your shoulder, or some people can wear it crossbody, when you open it, if you're wearing it to your the side of your body, you open it and the top handle that's attached to the top flap has, you know, will hit you in the ribs and kind of, it's uncomfortable is what I've heard. And I've tried on Coco handles in the boutique before and I definitely know exactly what they're talking about. You know, you open it, it's a very stiff top handle and it just kind of whacks you in the ribs area, rib area. So I would love to hear any of you Coco handle owners, what has been your experience? Is that a big nuisance for you when you wear the Coco handle? Does it typically hit you with that top handle when you're paying or opening the flap? Or is that not something that, you know, I should be concerned about? Also, size-wise, what do you feel is the best for capacity for every day? Do you feel like the mini, the original mini, not the extra mini, the mini or the small is a better size capacity-wise? Let me know, Coco handle owners. I know that will be super beneficial for me. Okay, and the second bag from Chanel that I am on the fence about is the Chanel 19. I know that it's so popular. Everyone loves it. And I definitely feel that it has the effect like the boy on me. And what I mean by that is, when it first came out, I was like, oh no, 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 no. That is not a silhouette that I like. I don't think it's gonna be classic. I don't think it's gonna be popular. I felt that, no, like, I'll pass. But again, kind of seeing it more and more regularly over time, it is very popular. I feel that it is very user friendly. I'm seeing it more on social media. Maybe it's one of those things that I am really being influenced by seeing photos of it. So I'm not sure. I definitely think that, you know, recently seeing it more, I'm starting to like it, but I just, again, want to hold my horses a little bit because for a long time I just was not into it. So I don't want to just jump the gun and then regret it. So Chanel 19 owners, please tell me what you think. What are the pros? What are the cons? I definitely would not get it in black. I think that's the most popular with the black leather, but I have too much black. So that's another thing too, is I'm not looking to add any more black. So I don't know, you know, if I did decide, okay, that is a bag for me and I wanna add it, I don't know what color I would go for. Okay guys, so those are the bags from a number of luxury designer houses that I am on the fence about. I just don't know. I go one day where I love it, another day where I'm not really feeling it, and I just don't know. So any perspective that you have, if any of you own these bags, or if you've just had any exposure to the bag, you've tried it on, or you found that it's for you because of this, or you didn't like this feature and you decided not to buy it because of a certain reason, any perspective that you have on any of these bags, I would truly appreciate that. So please let me know down in the comment section down below. Don't forget to like this video. I will link another one of my videos here and I'll see you in my next one. Thanks guys.